Everybody open up your mouth and declare that tonight.
You're a miracle worker.
You're a miracle worker.
Come on, anybody believe that in this place?
Sing, you're a miracle worker.
You're a miracle worker.
You are omnipotent, Jesus. Sing, you're a miracle worker.
We'll be right back. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Father, we are so grateful this day. We thank you for all your many blessings, God. We're so grateful to come to you this evening, Father. We're so grateful to come in prayer, Father, as a body of believers. And Father, we thank you for what you're doing in our lives today. We thank you that you're a God of miracles. And Father, even right now, we're praying today, just believing that you're hearing us and you're answering us. You're resetting us, Father, in such a moment in a So, Father, even right now, we thank you for how you blessed us to continue calling on your name, Father. So, even right now, we thank you. We praise you. We honor you, God. We're so grateful for what you're doing in our lives. We don't take it for granted, Father. We're truly grateful today. It's in you that we live, move, and have our being, Father. We thank you for you being with us all day long, Father. You've kept us. You kept us from harm and danger, Father. And so, Father, right now, we just want to just lift up our voices and say hallelujah and thank you, Lord, for you are good to us. You are a good, good Father. We praise you, Lord, for you are an amazing Father. Your love is unconditional. Your love is unfailing. And Father, we thank you today for how you have brought us into the awareness, Father, of not only whose we are, but who you are. And so we thank you for who you are today, Father. We give you glory. Not what you've done, but just for who you are, we give you glory. We give you glory because you are Abba, Father. You are Yahweh, and we thank you for that today. And we just praise your holy name, Father. And we're just so grateful for how you're moving in the midst of our lives today, how you have reestablished us. There's a resetting that's happening in the body of Christ. And so, Father, as your vessels today, I pray that we would really pay attention to what you're doing, what you're speaking to us, Father. Nothing catches you off guard until you have given us dominion, you have given us power and authority, and you're wanting us to release that in the earth, operate in that power and authority. And so, Father, forgive us for not operating in that, in what you have already granted us. And so, Father, we cannot blame you for us not operating in that power and authority. So today, Father, let us take what you've granted us and appropriate it in our lives that we may operate in your spirit. Hallelujah. And by your power. Hallelujah. There's so much happening in this world, Father, that we need your power. We need to operate in the power of the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. We need your power, Lord, your Holy Ghost power. Hallelujah. So, Father, we thank you that we can begin to bind and loose. You've already given us authority to do that as well. And so even right now, I pray that we begin to bind the hand of the enemy. He said, whatever we bind on earth is bound in heaven. Whatever we loose on earth is loosed in heaven. So, Father, let us operate in the authority that you've granted us as your children. And Father, we know that this is a faith walk, but we walk by faith. And so, Father, even right now, if our faith is not strengthened, we're even now asking for more faith today, and we know faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. And so, Father, we understand what faith is, and so today we all have a measure of faith, but we're asking for an increase. Hallelujah. And that comes through the word of God. Hallelujah. Take us deeper, Lord. Take us deeper, Lord. Hallelujah.
Take us deeper, Lord, that we may know you in a real way, that it will go beyond just knowledge, but it would be an experience. It would be an awakening that we truly know, hallelujah, that it's in you that we live, move, and have our being. It's in you that whatever we speak, it shall be established, hallelujah. That this is a knowing as a believer that we can operate in today, that we're beginning to snatch our children back from the hand of the enemy. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord. And so we thank you for what Christ has done for us, that we would do our part and now take what Christ has given unto us and operate in that, that you may be glorified. You said you wish that none would perish, but all come to repentance. And so, Father, right now you've given us power, and that power is very critical for us to be witnesses, for us to win souls, Father, for us to lay hands on the sick, and for us to deal with the enemy. And so today, Father, we pray for more faith that we may operate in and not wait on others to do what you've called us to do, but to operate in the power, in the authority that you've granted us. Hallelujah. And so, Father, I thank you that you did not give us the spirit of fear, but power, love, and a sound mind. And so we come against the spirit of fear, the spirit of doubt, the spirit of unbelief. We come against in the name of Jesus, that we may truly believe what you've spoken. It is so in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. It is so in the name of Jesus. And I thank you for that today, Father. I thank you for a renewed mind. Thank you for refreshing us. Thank you for setting us. Thank you for the mantle, hallelujah, that you're giving unto us today. Thank you for passing the mantle, hallelujah, that we're taking the cloak and we're saying, yes, Lord, we will do what you say. And Father, we're saying, use us today for your kingdom and for your glory. And Father, let us impact lives around us. Let us not continue to see death, murders, hallelujah, homicide amongst our young people. Hallelujah. But let us operate in the power and authority to reclaim, hallelujah, that we don't just let the enemy continue to snatch our children. We're taking them back by force. Thank you for giving us the courage, the fortitude that we need, Father, to get back in the race and do what thus said the Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you for our young people. Father, we're praying for them right now in the name of Jesus, that we would be able to encourage them, inspire them, uplift them to be true believers, born again believers, that we can lead them, that we can love them, guide them into all truth. And so, Father, even right now, we pray that we can be the light for our youth today, that we will be transparent, that we will live a life that glorifies you before them, that they will see Christ Jesus, hallelujah, that they won't just hear us telling them to do things, but they will see us living accordingly. And so we thank you for that today, Father. Forgive us for not obeying your word, not obeying what you've told us to do. You told us to teach your word, teach your statutes to our children and our children's children. Hallelujah. And so, Father, we ask you to have mercy on us. Give us another opportunity to teach our children and our children's children and the generation thereafter. Hallelujah. That we may walk in obedience to your will and to your way. And so we thank you for that today, Father, for another chance, another opportunity, for you are God of miracles. You are a God of miracles, Lord. Hallelujah. And I've seen you work miracles, God, not only in the Bible, but in our lives. In our own lives, you have worked miracles. And Father, we're asking you to endow us with the power to work miracles. For us to operate, Jesus says that we should do greater works. So, Father, let us have the faith to speak to the mountain. And the mountain is cast into the sea. Let us have the faith to believe what we're speaking. Not just rhetoric, not just words, but to believe it. And it is so. In the mighty name of Jesus. And we praise you today, Father. We thank you for bringing us together one more time. We say thank you, Lord. When we give you praise, we give you glory. Thank you that we're able to come together one more time and be on one accord, Father. Thank you for the spirit of unity even right now. And we thank you and we praise your name today. We're so grateful for what you're doing in our lives. Hallelujah, Father. And we thank you that we're taking the kingdom back by force. We thank you, Father. We cast the enemy back to where he come from now in the mighty name of Jesus. But we do have the power and we do have the authority. Let us connect and operate together on one accord. And the power of God fell as they were in one place on one accord. Hallelujah, Father, we thank you that we're in one place on one accord. And we thank you for the power of the Holy Ghost, even right now. Thank you for refreshing us. Hallelujah. Thank you for refreshing us, God. We are refreshed. We're rejuvenated. Thank you, Father, for giving us strength where we've been weak. Hallelujah. Thank you for building us up where we've been torn down, Father. Thank you right now in the name of Jesus. We bless you today, Father. We're so grateful. Thank you for this beautiful day, Father. And we just praise your holy name. We're rejoicing, Father. And we're mourning, even with those that are mourning right now. And we're praying for the family, Father. We're praying for the Lockett family and the Matoir family. We're praying for them, Father. We pray that they're encouraged. Touch like only you can, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. For Father, you said that you would be with us always. So this is a moment, Father, that only you can comfort. We can be available as vessels, Father, but only you can comfort a mother. Hallelujah. Only you can comfort a father. And so we're praying right now that you would comfort as we're praying for the family, Father. We love you. And we praise you for this body of believers, Father. We're so grateful that we're able to be here one for another. That we're praying and that we're available, that we're willing vessels to please you, Father, to glorify you. And we're saying, use us in the earth to impact someone's life, that they may see you, not just in words, but also in deed. And we thank you for that today. Keep us safe the rest of the evening, Father. Let us arrive to our homes safely, Father. Let us rest well, Father. Thank you for protection over the dangerous highways. Thank you for keeping us safe in our homes. And thank you for protecting us and delivering us from the evil one. And we praise you for that today, Father. We give you glory. And let us be mindful of our surroundings, that we may be watching and praying and trusting and obeying. And we praise you today, Father. And we give you all the glory this day. We thank you again. We love you, Lord. We invite you in every area of our lives. We don't take anything for granted. We say, Lord, you are welcome in this place. Hallelujah. In every space we're in, you are welcome. Hallelujah. And we praise you today. No compromise. But we say, Lord, you are welcome in this place. And we do love you and we do praise you today. Until we meet again, we say, thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. And to God be the glory as your vessels. In Jesus' name, we pray. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Amen.